Over the last 1 week, Chennai recorded poor to very poor air quality in several parts of the city. While the state government has said that there is no reason to worry, it is certainly safer to know how air pollution can affect our lungs and what we can do to prevent it. Dr. Rajiv Santosham, a Chennai-based cardiothoracic surgeon, gives us more details.
Air pollution is a lot of things. It can be pollution from anywhere from secondhand smoke to Diwali crackers to badly maintained cars, industrial pollution, different forms of fumes, burning of trash, everything. All of these can affect the heart and the lungs in a similar fashion how smoking affects the heart and lungs. Everybody is at risk, but the people who are more at risk are people extremes of age, like babies, small children, and people who are older, asthmatics, people with chronic bronchitis, and people who are in confined in small lower socioeconomic status, where they are in small groups. These are the people who are usually more at risk. Probably small things like not bursting firecrackers during Diwali, New Year, etc. Using of certain types of masks. People just wear cloth masks and surgical masks like this, which is not going to do anything to you. Specific masks like N95 masks. It's produced by this company called 3M. That is the most popular company. N95. So you use that. It covers your mouth and your face. When you go out, maybe that can help you protect your lungs from air pollution. There are some antioxidants in things like green tea or some stuff like that, which might help maybe 1%. I mean, steam inhalation apparently supposed to help. What you do is you inhale steam, that goes to your lungs and liquefies your the thick secretions. So with that, your secretions can start coming out. And other things are like, there are some things you can learn from a physiotherapist, some vibration techniques that will. You can tap your chest, that will bring out these secretions. Postural drainage, where you position yourself in a particular position so the secretion starts coming out. And controlled coughing, when you do this postural drainage and steam inhalation, you do controlled coughing. You don't cough violently, but you cough in a controlled fashion so you get out these secretions. So I always wonder, why do these women who don't ever smoke, who are from a well-off family, who don't have pollutants inside their house, keep getting this? It turns out that pollution inside the house, like I said, cooking, with use of incense. I mean, incense I never knew was a pollutant. I just read up about this recently, and I attended a couple of lectures. And I realized incense is a pollutant. People keep it for religious reasons, I mean, and that itself is a pollutant. I mean, because I'm an asthmatic, and as a child, when I had to go to some places where they were burning incense, it used to get aggravated. I personally know it, and I've seen lots of patients, non-smokers with COPD and emphysema, and it's probably due to pollution and internal pollution inside the house itself.